Welcome to the second episode of Pimp My Ship. Today I'm starting with a career ship. It's meant to be a combat ship to defend the cargo mothership. So let's look at design choices and things that need to be changed. First of all, there's no need to have this amount of side armor. It's a huge waste. It's just weighing the whole ship down. In fact, you probably only need one layer. Unless you're taking a lot of side hits, but you've also got a shield. In fact, the sides are honestly better defended than the front, which is not how it should be. Another main issue is this right here seems like our only front weapons, and then we've got the four at the back. That's not enough weapons for a ship this size. So this has severe under firepower issues. The flak, it's not, I don't know about having the flak on this. I guess it can stay. Shield placement's a little bit weird. This shield's unnecessary. I think we can make a little bit better of pathing to the generators. I think this ship can run on fewer generators or bigger generators, like two big ones instead of four small ones. In fact, all this back section can run on one of the medium generators if done right. All the point defense is actually not doing much because it doesn't have any energy getting to it. Like, to get energy to this point defense right here, it's going to take that long, awkward winding path. It says 8 meters, but every meter inside of a building counts twice because crew moves 50% speed. So these point defense are not getting used pretty much at all. This one's just a one and done. You're never refilling that one. Same over here. These point defense just can't really act. You need to use storages for point defense if you want them to actually stay up in a battle and defend against herds of missiles. The use of ammo factories can make sense in a career quite a bit, but high explosive missile factories aren't as effective. Like, missiles, in terms of like density, missiles per storage space, you get about twice as many missiles compared to if you use the iron and the sulfur. Versus for ammo, you get about 5 times as many. So it makes a lot more sense to use an ammo factory over a missile factory. You rarely ever see missile factories in competitive gameplay in terms of like PvP tournaments. Now, it can make sense to have missile factories in career mode because a lot of people don't want to have to bother to constantly go refill with missiles after every fight, so they want to have a lot of storage and they don't want to have to constantly like have crew unload from another ship. So these engines, I always suggest having the engine on the side be a like falling off edge engine, be the bigger ones. That way they can use more of the engine room for less space around it taken up. It's like that one, you can have one of these or you can have like one of these. So it increases cost efficiency there. So all these engine rooms can have improved cost efficiency. Let's get started with the actual building. First of all, we gotta mess with the crew. And there is a little line down the middle. This ship can be made one block thinner very, very easily, in fact. So I'm gonna start by deleting things that I don't think I'm gonna be using very much. I always just redo the crew. It's much easier on me that way. And one issue you'll notice with this crew, you can still see them, is they aren't particularly close to weapons. I mean, they're close enough to reactors here, that's good. But these crew in the middle are gonna have a struggle getting to anything. And we can put that control room down somewhere else later. First thing I wanna look at is the front. It definitely needs a lot more firepower in this ship. It just is not running as is. I'm actually gonna remove the flak if I wanna re-add them on the sides. Change. I'm gonna come out here and instead of putting that flak, we're gonna put point defense. You notice you can put the crew facing into the reactor, but it's actually faster to have them walk on the walkway like that. assign these guys to the reactor, but what I'm gonna do is actually assign each side to stuff like this. The reason I did that, and by the way, a lot of the times you can have a separate shield crew. The reason I did that is because I don't want people walking across the reactor. Because walking across the reactor is what, like 8 movement points, which is pretty much the same as traveling all the way out to one of these. So it's never worth it. Let's table thinking about that for a bit. I'm just not going to worry about it because I'm going to figure out other stuff and other energy balances. Like if these point defense end up getting deleted, which they might, then I have to do this because we need side defense. But also I might want to have things built another way. Anyway, let's get working on this rear. I'm not going to touch these. You know, for missiles, I really just find that the best way to do it is something like this is like the most effective way. But because of the lack of surface area, you tend to want to build your missiles. In order to fully use your missiles, you need 6 crew and then operator crews to separate out. See, because I'm doing it there, that way the crew are closer to this door. Do need an increase in forward thrust, so I'm actually going to completely redesign this side piece, and I think I could just throw in a little bit extra, something like this. I'll fix these problems later, but maybe we can have staged thrust like that. Anyway, the reason I put like this is so I can throw engines out here. So now we can do... Actually, we're not going to do this. We're going to sink it in. There we go. Honestly, just going to leave the back of this pretty bare. We have enough point defense around it. Notice how I assign these crew. This guy is assigned to the end pieces and not to the storage. The reason that is because I don't want them refilling the storage. I want them staying in that area. I'm gonna make them only battery, but it's not gonna matter. See, because I assigned these guys to there. Actually, I can unassign. It's not gonna cause any issues. All right, I did a little bit of testing and this ship goes almost 120, which is crazy fast. So it is a very light attack vehicle, but it is definitely more powerful than what we've got going on over here. I'm tempted to cut off a segment of engines, honestly. That's some pretty good top speed without those other sets of engines, not gonna lie. I don't know if I'm gonna use that second set compared to what we have over here. Yeah. As long as it goes above 80, it's gonna be more than enough. So we really don't need this second set, which means we can just delete them because we need to keep it within the price range. concerned about the energy issues we're getting at the front. Might not seem too bad, but the issue is that when I want to maintain shields, it's going to become an issue. Main reason I'm looking at this is I'm thinking that perhaps I only need one reactor. What's left in the ship design is managing this middle part. I think we can do it much better. First of all, these guys need to have crew nearby. I also kind of want to push this back one. Honestly, now that this thing's closer to the middle, I'm not as worried about armor on it. I just didn't want to write against the surface. So now that it's positioned there, and we're not gonna have the same issue we're having over here because these crew are assigned to the reactor, we're gonna have things work out better. See, this is a problem we have right now. We just have too much space left over. It's a funny problem to have. Keeping to the original structure and shape of the ship is very difficult. Alright, we've just completed our paint design. It's nothing special, but I wanted to get something on there. You can always add a little bit extra, but basic design is a little bit of a layering look with a shadow effect using fades. Anyway, let's compare the ships and look what we changed. We have a lot more missiles, and they're going to fire much more often when they have ammo. Our engines, we have a lot more engines. This ship goes around 100 and around... so 60, almost 70 in reverse. Over here we have around 70 and around 15 in reverse. Also has a little bit of strafe to it. This ship has minimal strafe with those side thrusters, mostly for turning. We've added a lot of storage. That was mostly because we had the space for it. And if we want to store materials to be used to create missiles and ammo out of a fight, we're not going to use it in a fight. And notice that we added cannons up here. That's so we can run the entire front on one large reactor. And these shields are going to be very good at staying up because our crew prioritize shields. All of our point defense are put on capacitors, so they're actually able to shoot back and maintain their energy to fight missiles for a much longer period of time. I did add an extra hyperdrive because I felt like it, but it was not really that necessary. So we're running on two reactors, costing much cheaper. This ship is actually only slightly more expensive when it has a lot more weapons. We did drop the flak, Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Let me know how I can improve this video. It's actually going to be edited by the creator of this ship over here. And I'm going to try out different editing styles for this series because I'm not entirely sure how I'm going to do it, given it's not really scripted the same way my other videos are.